Oh dear.
Oh god. Please stop!
Fortnite has decided to give the PUBG-obsessed internet something to talk about by releasing a quality competitor of the same genre, with some different mechanics, better optimization, and free! However, if you're stuck with an integrated GPU or a computer from 2010, you might want to make some sacrifices to get started on this game. Welcome to the Low Spec Gamer. If you are new to this channel, I explore ways of increasing game performance on low-end computers by sacrificing everything else, and after spending God knows how many hours reading documentation on the Unreal Engine 4, I have some initial tweaks to share so you can get started on this game. Fortnite is an early access game developed by Epic Games, the creators of the Unreal Engine, so it is not a surprise this game is running on the latest version of that. The game's Battle Royale mode is free to play, and the whole game is expected to go free next year. It is also not a surprise that this game uses the resources of the engine very well, and that it has a fair amount of graphical options. But if after dropping all to the minimum you still need more performance, you might want to head to the configuration file located on your hidden app data folder, local, Fortnite game, config, Windows client, and the file we will use is called engine.ini. We will add some commands on assistant settings section. First, you might have noticed that the game has an internal resolution scaler mapped to some options in the menu. This changes internal resolution without affecting the readable UI. However, you can specify any values you want in a multiplier with screen percentage. For example, 20 is 20% of normal resolution. This will override the game's setting. Outside resolution, we have a couple of interesting things to look at. Let's start with something small. For some reason, I noticed that disabling grass in the menu did not work properly on several of the computers I tested with. So you can disable grass completely with these commands. More interestingly, you have these commands that control texture quality. I have noticed that if you use MIP bias 10, you can reduce the resolution of the textures quite under what the game usually considers as low. Another amusing tweak is draw distance. View distance scale controls this, and 0.1 being a particularly low value. This game has an interesting system to manage draw distance while still maintaining visibility over long distances. Draw distances work as you will expect on certain elements that will only be rendered when closer to you, as well as grass if you have it enabled. But you might have noticed another thing going on. When players are outside your render radius, they have no animations and moving bursts. And if you have view distance scale set to 0.1, they will only be animated very close to you. This will probably save some resources, but I do not need to tell you how this puts you in a disadvantage. Ha, come on, but when has that stopped us? I decided to test this on a dual-core Intel Celeron G1840 and it's included Intel HD overclocked to 1600 MHz, a setup that I could not play PUBG with no matter what I did, and got some interesting results while playing the free-to-play Battle Royale mode. You can notice that the buildings are visible after a certain distance. The three render distances, when you're really far, you get some simple objects to know where you're heading to, and when you get close, they vanish, and then they pop up again as they get closer to your actual render area. See? That is actually pretty interesting how the game manages that. Of course, that is made so you usually won't notice it, but, well... Wow. It's like every single part of my system is bottlenecked. That's interesting. There's a player there! See? Oh my god. Oh god, this is terrible. I'm fighting a flying man! Oh, I can hit him! I can totally hit him even with the draw distance. This is fantastic. No, no, come back here. They're his. Haha, I can see his janky movements. Wahoo! This is the weirdest shooting game I have ever played. This is so bizarre. This is so bizarre. Whoa! No, 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 no! Build a barrier! Build a fuck! Okay, that didn't go as well as I expected. That was interesting. Let's try that again. Look at those janky-ass players.
We have remove animations almost. This is so bizarre to watch. Yep, okay, we're getting closer. Look at all these trees just popping up right in front of us. Oh god, that's good, that's good. How in the world am I still alive? So, my strategy so far is, since the draw distance is making it really hard to find enemies at a distance, I'm getting into situations where enemies get really close to me. Pretty sure that's going to work. I need to find some place where I can keep to myself. I need to find some place where I can draw them close to me. How the heck am I still alive? This is literally the least players I have ever seen. I have never gotten this far on any game of this genre, ever. Okay! Look at all these fancy weapons, oh my godness. Come on, heal. I still got a chance, I'm among the 5+ players! I can't believe this is actually happening. This is literally the last house in the fucking game. One. It's literally one. He's coming for me. I feel him. I see him on the corner. How in the world have I survived this long? Chance. Oh my god, come on. Oh, once again, one health. This is really impressive. It's 4 players and that was my last health pack. What was that? Okay, some shit's going down. Did I just... what? Well, that was literally a rocket launcher. I placed 4th! I literally just placed 4th! With the settings! That's... okay, that's it. I'm done. I'm never going to get anything better than that.
That is all for this video. I'm pleasantly surprised about this game, so you might see me playing more of this in the future. Thank you to everyone who donates in Patreon for your continued support. See you all very soon.
Wow, he literally blew away half the house where I was staying. That is impressive.